Alright folks, welcome back to Kerok Avalon's Gaming. We're in Medieval Dynasty and we're overlooking my orchard. This is a playthrough that I have on my channel that I will be showing you a video of soon. So this is a fun game. I have some repairs I need to do over here. Medieval Dynasty is a fun little game that I've been playing for a while now. Just had a recent update called the Air Update. Highly recommend that you check it out. So this video is a channel update video. I do these regularly on my channel when I've finished a playthrough. We just finished the Lord of the Rings Online Hunter Travel Skills Quests playthrough. I think that was 6 videos. So playthroughs on my channel are a little untraditional. We don't just play one game for months and months until we're done. Okay. My channel is a gaming channel. It's not a specific game channel. Like, this isn't a Valheim channel. This isn't a Lord of the Rings Online channel. This isn't a Medieval Dynasty channel. This is Kerok Avalon's Gaming. And I am Kerok. I am a one-person show. I am a Gen X gamer. I'm in my 50s. I started gaming in 1982 or 83, I think, when I got an Atari console. And I've been gaming for 40 years ever since, and it's been a blast. It's my hobby. I have a full-time job, I have a family, I've got all that stuff. And I created this channel because I enjoy gaming, and I thought this would be a really cool hobby for me. Why not share it with other people? One thing I've learned over the years as I've aged is some people think the older you are, it doesn't make sense for you to game, and I say, well, that's BS, because I think it's a blast. It's a fun hobby. It's not something that takes over my life, okay? And that's kind of what I want to explain to you a little bit in this video. So before I get going, let me say thank you. Thank you for taking your time to watch my content. I really appreciate it. Please smash that like button. Please subscribe. Please share the video. All that stuff really helps the channel out, and I really, really appreciate the support. So, where have we been? We just finished a Lotro series, and the next series is going to be Medieval Dynasty Unique Build Locations. That should start next Tuesday, okay? So, anytime I'm doing a playthrough on my channel, those videos will be on Tuesdays. So, if the playthrough is going to be 10 videos, every Tuesday for the next 10 weeks, you will see the next version of that playthrough, unless something extraordinary happens, like I lose power or something like that. And then on Thursdays you get a standalone video. Now most Thursdays I post a Valheim video. Valheim is the other game, another big game on my channel. And Saturdays you will either get a standalone video, a stream, or both. Saturdays is kind of a toss-up for me. It really depends on family, friends, etc. Now that the summer's winding down a little bit, I'll probably be more available. But for the most part this summer I've been pretty consistent, so that's good. So to recap, what you're going to get on my gaming channel is on Tuesdays you should get the playthrough, whatever that is, the next video in that series. So if that interests you, definitely you want to stay tuned every Tuesday. Thursdays are standalone videos, they're random, but for the most part they've been Valheim seed discovery videos, which is a big chunk of my channel at this point. And Saturdays is, again, toss up. Now, the structure of my channel is a little different. This is a gaming channel, meaning I just show you the games as I play them. You know, there's no heavy editing, there's no big splash screens, there's nothing like that. I'm not doing this to make money. This is just an extension of my hobby. Okay, I was gaming in 1993, 94, before YouTube was even created. Okay, I've been gaming for a long time. So for me, I thought, well, you know, what's a good extension of my hobby? And what's something that maybe years from now, you know, if I wanted to, as I transition to retired life, if I wanted to do full-time, I could. I think a gaming channel is a great thing. I think, you know, there's a lot of Gen X gamers out there who game a little bit, maybe not as much as our younger cohorts. And I think it's cool when we're out there and we let people know that, hey, it's okay if you're older and you're gaming. It's a hobby. And, you know, It's mainstream. It's not just young people. Lots of people like to game. It's fun. So on my channel, what you see is the actual gameplay. If it takes me an hour to do a quest, you're going to see the full hour. I'm not going to cut it, edit it, splice it. Now, some people say, well, that's lazy content. Okay, maybe. I could do editing and all of that, but then it becomes a job, then it becomes work, right? And for me, I'm not interested in another job. I have a full-time job. And for me, I'm a gamer, and I would like to share it with people. And I don't want it to be a full-time job. Now, on my channel, you're not going to see monetization. Any ads that you see are put here by YouTube. I don't have an Etsy store, so there's no mugs, no t-shirts to buy. I'm not shilling anything. There are no sponsors. I will not take sponsors. Don't have a Patreon, don't have a Subscribestar. I may do that in the future, but I don't have one of those. So it doesn't cost you anything to be here. These videos are all free. And again, if there is a ad on the channel, it's because YouTube put it there, not because I put it there. So there's that. So I don't want your money. Your subscription would be great. Your likes would be fantastic, but you don't ever have to pay to be here. What else can I share with you? So where we're going next. So again, we're going to go to Medieval Dynasty next. The next series is going to be about unique build locations. Now, this is one of them. This is not necessarily a unique location, but it's a unique build because it's a complete orchard and brewery. And I sell booze out of here. It's a fun little playthrough. That'll be about 5 or 6 videos. I usually do an intro video for the series, and then I do the series after that. So I think it's going to be 6. That should start on a Tuesday soon, probably next Tuesday. We'll see. After that, I'm not sure where I'm going to go next. I think I'll probably do a couple of Valheim videos, but not for series. I don't know yet what the next series is going to be after this, but it'll be probably something a little bit more extensive than 5 or 6 videos, excuse me, but we'll see. What you can expect in the near future. So you're going to see Medieval Dynasty on the channel. You're also going to continue to see Valheim. The other thing that you will see is a lot of the live streams for the next couple of months will probably be Guild Wars 2, Medieval Dynasty, Valheim, and maybe some LOTRO. So the new game in there is Guild Wars 2. It's not a new game. They've just celebrated their 10th anniversary. They just came out on Steam as a free-to-play player. I'm checking it out. Guild Wars 2 is an interesting game. I like it. I'm not 100% sold on it. I don't know that it's gonna take up a huge chunk of my rotation of gaming, but I think that I'm gonna devote enough time to it in the classes and learn a couple of them where I can safely say, you know, this is for me or it isn't. But again, that you'll see that happening. So, you know, that'll be a good chunk of the live streams going forward. What's in the distant future? 2022, I don't see any games coming that are absolute must-plays for me. There's a couple out there that I'd like to try, though. There's one game I've kept my eye on. It's called This Land Is Your Land. It's an interesting survival type game, but the reviews are mixed, and I'm a little gun shy to pull the trigger. However, if that ever goes on sale, for a decent price, I may do that. Now, there's another game in my library that I do enjoy playing. I've invested some time in, and I'd like to do a little bit more. It's called Hunter Call of the Wild. It's a hunting simulation. I know hunting isn't for everybody. Some people have very strong feelings about hunting. I've hunted many times in the past. I haven't hunted recently because I don't need to, because I make money. I don't need to kill animals for food. I can go shopping. But when I was younger, I did work on a farm, live on a farm for a little while, and we hunted for food. And I enjoy hunting, bow hunting, But at any rate, that game may appear in the distant future too. I'm thinking sometime in the winter, I don't know. For 2023, there's two games that I'm keeping my eyes on. The first one is Hogwarts Legacy. Now, I think I will play that, although I don't know that I'm going to do it right at release. Meaning, I played Elden Ring right at release, and it was a fun game, but I kind of burnt out on it quickly. That game is a little unique. It's a tough game, Elden Ring, and I think, everybody was playing it, but I just that star faded real quick for me. I like Dark Souls games. I think that would be something cool to revisit later on, but I'm not sure if I'm gonna do Hogwarts Legacy right when it comes out, because I think it'll be saturated, meaning wherever you turn, you're gonna see Hogwarts Legacy videos, etc. And that's not because I want the channel to be unique, or I want to play games that no one else is doing. I just don't see, when I go into a game, I really try to get into it, and then if I get overwhelmed with the game, I burn out faster, right? Like, I'm such a casual gamer, like I want to play a game where I can play like once a week. Like, that's why MMOs are great. So, but I am keeping my eyes on Hogwarts Legacy. The other thing I'm keeping my eyes on is Ashes of Creation. Now, I don't know if 2023 that game is going to come out. Okay, I have no idea, but I suspect in 2023 we're going to get a lot more news about that game, and we're going to know about when it's going to come out. My guess for that game is going to be 2024 sometime, but I'm not 100% sure on that. So those are the two games in the distant future that I'm keeping my eye on. But for right now, you can expect to see Lord of the Rings Online, Valheim, Guild Wars 2, Medieval Dynasty, and a couple of other videos splashed in there. Maybe some Skyrim, maybe some Mount and Blade. So 2022 has been a great year for me. What I'd like to say finally is my goal for 2022 is I'd like to get to 500 subscribers by the end of the year. So what I can then start to do is YouTube has a feature where you can send out notifications to your subscribers of when you're going live. That would be cool, because I don't always know when I'm going to be able to go live. Sometimes it works out, I can go live every night, and that's cool, but I'd like to get to the point where I can set up a schedule and then send people, hey, Saturday I'm going to be playing Medieval Dynasty Live, and I can send that out on a Thursday. So if people want to come, they can. So that's the goal for 2022. I hope to hit it. So far, you guys have been really, really great. You've been liking the videos, you've been commenting on the videos, you've been subscribing, and I really, really appreciate that. Let's see if we can get to 500 by the end of the year. That would be really, really cool. Anyways, I hope you're going to join me for the next series in Medieval Dynasty. That should start a week from when this video is posted, and you will see a little bit more in depth of this orchard, and it is getting towards nighttime. And nighttime in Medieval Dynasty, you should probably go to sleep. Anyways, thanks so much for watching. I really appreciate it, and I'll talk to you again soon.